Hi guys, welcome back to Read With Me, LG. I'm glad you've joined me today for another book. Today we have a really fun one about a special puppy. So today is How Smudge Came. And this is a book about Smudge. And it was, the story is written by Nan Gregory. So that's the author. And the pictures are drawn by Ron Lightburn. So the illustrator is Ron. So we're going to jump right in to How Smudge Came. If there's one thing Cindy knows, this is no place for a puppy. Up goes the puppy, tucked into her bag. Home goes Cindy. So this is the puppy. She sees the puppy eating in the trash can in the rain. So Cindy gets the puppy. If there's one thing Cindy knows, it's don't let anyone see. Cindy sneaks upstairs to her bedroom. Is that you, Cindy? Yes, Mrs. Watson. You're late. Dinner's getting cold. Right there, Mrs. Watson. Puppy goes under Cindy's bed. So here's Cindy sneaking in the puppy upstairs. There is the puppy that she has hidden under her bed. At the big table, everyone is eating already. Cindy fills her napkin with stew for the puppy. No dessert, Cindy? No thanks. Her chair squeaks as she pushes it back. Up in her room, puppy eats hungrily. Dear little puppy, croons Cindy. If there's one thing Cindy knows, this is her dog. So here's Cindy. She doesn't want dessert because she wants to go hurry and feed her puppy. So she takes her extra stew upstairs and it's feeding Smudge. Knock, knock on her door. Cindy, into the closet goes puppy. The door opens. They never wait for her to answer. Cindy, John is drying the dishes. You can put away. Cindy concentrates on the plates. Don't break a plate, Cindy. Think about the plate, not the puppy. Back in her room. Oh, puppy, what did you do? Cindy cleans up after the puppy. Puppy sleeps under Cindy's covers. If there's one thing Cindy knows, this is her best friend. So here's Cindy carrying the dishes, helping put away the stuff. And this is Cindy snuggling with her puppy. Ring, ring. Get up, Cindy. Get dressed. Go to work. What about puppy? Take him along. Cindy works in a house called hospice. Dustpans and buckets and disinfectant. Up and down the halls, in and out of the rooms. Cleaning, cleaning, cleaning. She likes to make things shine. Into the pocket of her big yellow apron goes the puppy. Out of the closet come the brooms and mops and the polishers. Up and down the hall goes Cindy. In and out of the rooms. So here's Cindy and the puppy at work. Do you see the puppy in her apron? I see it. Here's Jan, who isn't very old, but he is ugly with disease and he is going to die. Sometimes tears trickle out of his nearly blind eyes. Clank, is that you, Cindy? Yep. In her apron pocket, the puppy whimpers. What's that sound, Cindy? What sound? Didn't you hear it? Cindy puts the puppy on Jan's bed. Oh my, a puppy. Can you see him? Not really, just a smudge in the dark. Cindy smiles her slow smile. Same when I first saw him, smudge in the dark. So here is the patient in the bed. He's nearly blind, but he can see just a little. So when he held up the puppy, he saw a smudge. At lunch, Cindy eats her sandwich on the back lawn. Smudge eats a bit of bread and sniffs around, then back into the apron for the afternoon. When Cindy gets home, people are shouting, "Cindy, what's going on in your room? What did you have in your room last night?" So here's Cindy and the puppy. This is when she gets home. And they're asking her about what was in her room. Cindy's not telling. Her lips are tight and her eyes are squinty. She breathes through her nose. "Cindy, stop being silly." Cindy is leaving now. Someone blocks her. Someone opens her bag. Hands snatch the puppy. "Smudge!" "Cindy, be reasonable." Now that they have the puppy, everyone is reasonable. You can't have a puppy. You can't take care of it. You work all day. What would the puppy do all day while you are at work? "Take him with me," Cindy says, but they drown her with their words. She tries to tune out. SPCA. She hears, "Good home." She will not weep, but tears squeeze by. She starts to hum. So here's them taking the puppy. And this is her. And does she look happy? No, she looks sad. She has a tear and she looks sad. "Go to your room, Cindy." Next day, Jan props himself up. "Where's Smudge?" "What would the puppy do all day? You can't take care. You can't have a puppy." Cindy is furious. Jan lies back. That's her going to her room that night, and she's sad. And this is her sad at work. After lunch, Cindy is back in Jan's room. "What's SPCA? "A place that looks after animals until someone comes to take them. To a good home?" "That's right," Cindy snorts. "Where is it?" "I'm not sure. East side somewhere." Cindy brings the phone book. "Find it, please, Jan." "Cindy, I can't see. I can't read the phone book." "Who then?" "Carmen, maybe." Cindy finds Carmen in the TV room. Carmen writes the address on a piece of paper. Cindy folds it carefully. It's far away, but Cindy has a bus pass. If there's one thing Cindy knows, it's how to get around. So this is her looking. It's like a reflection in a window, and she's looking out, trying to figure out what to do. This is her asking for help from Carmen. When a bus stops, Cindy shows the paper to the driver. "Take the number 9 all the way to Knight Street," the driver tells her. "Good luck." SPCA keeps Smudge in a cage. The floor is hard and cold. He lies on papers. "Good home." At closing time, the clerk tells her, "Come back on Saturday at 10 if you want the puppy." So here she is trying to figure out which bus to take. And here she is visiting Smudge. "I'm getting Smudge on Saturday," she tells Jan. "They give him away on Saturday. Saturday is chore day at the group home." "Cindy, what's wrong? You usually like to clean." "Dusting done. Cindy is gone like a leaf in the wind." She is panting at the desk. "I've come for my dog." "Which dog is that?" "My puppy, small and black. Smudge." "Sorry. All the puppies went this morning. Come back next week. We're sure to have more." So this is her running out. But they told her she didn't make it in time. Let's see what happens next. Cindy sits in the park for a long time, but the hurt won't stop. Every time she breathes, if there's one thing Cindy doesn't know, it's how to find that puppy. Crying won't help. Cindy makes a whistle with a blade of grass between her thumbs. "Here's Smudge, here's Smudge." There's no place to go but home. So here is Cindy sad on the bench, and this is her finally giving up and walking home because she doesn't know what else to do. "Cindy, there's a phone message." What does Cindy care for messages? She lies on her bed and hums. "Cindy, they want you at the hospice house first thing in the morning. You aren't in trouble, are you?" At hospice house, everyone is in the living room. Jan is up. Jan never gets up. Carmen, too. Is the TV broken? What's going on? Is there trouble? If there's one thing Cindy doesn't need, it's another scolding. She starts to tune out. I mean, not listen. So this is them at the home telling her she needs to go to the work tomorrow morning. This is her at work. And she's just feeling sorry for herself. She says, nope, I don't want to be here. Cindy, we have something for you. Cindy, look. Something soft in her arms. Something cold nuzzles her chin. Cindy opens her eyes. Smudge! We'll keep him here, says Jan. For you, Cindy. For all of us. If there's one thing Cindy knows, this is the perfect place for a puppy. So the people, the doctor, and the patients decided that they could have Smudge there, and Cindy would get to help take care of him, and they'd get to snuggle him. So that was the happy story, is that Cindy might not be able to have him at her house, but Mr. Jan, who is friends with Cindy, knew that they could have him at the home. So, at the hospice home. So that was how Smudge came. Personally, I love all stories about dogs, because I just like dogs. So I thought that was a really sweet story. And I hope you guys enjoyed it too. And I hope you'll join me next time for another Read With Me LG. Bye bye.